What's up, Ratha here. This is the second part of the SolidWorks for Absolute Beginners series. And in this video, I'm going to walk you through how to attach all the Lego train parts together to form what we call an assembly. So by the end of the video, you'll have something that looks like this and does this. Hey, I'm Ratha. I've been using SolidWorks professionally for over 10 years, and I like to 3D model things with the intent of being manufactured. For me, creating an assembly serves two purposes in SolidWorks. One, to represent the entire 3D model if it was made of two or more components, and second, to show where each component lives. Now, if you'd like to follow along or want the files used in this tutorial for reference, head on over to rathasochenda.com/download to get your project files. Now, with that out of the way, let's get into it. Now that we modeled our 7 unique parts, we actually want to create an assembly, and it's going to look something like this. What we want is to put it together like a puzzle. And we also are gonna make an exploded view, something like this, so you can see how all the individual pieces go together. So to do that, let's create a new assembly. Go to Advanced, hit Assembly, hit okay. And then the first component we're gonna do is go to Browse. We're gonna use the main body train as our first component. Hit okay. Instead of selecting somewhere, just hit the OK here, and it's automatically going to bring it into the assembly file and lock it into position. So this is going to be where it's going to live permanently. And if we turn on our planes, you can see it lives there. Okay, let's turn those planes off. Hit F to zoom in. And now we're gonna insert our cab. And instead of hitting okay here, we're gonna actually select that somewhere on the workspace. And we're gonna constrain it. So to do that, hit mate. Let's make sure that this mate here sits flush with this top face here. Hit okay. And now that's fixed on that face. We want to make sure that this face is fixed on this face. So let's hit mate, hit this face, and hit this back face, hit okay. And now we want to make sure that this is in the center. Go to advanced mates, go to width, and then you're going to select this face, and then this face, and then this face. That's going to center that guy for us. So it should be now fixed. Perfect. Now we're gonna install the cap. Let's go to insert component, browse, and let's just make this a little bit bigger so we can see. So the cap is that piece there. Hit okay, and let's just click somewhere in the workspace. Same thing, hit mates, select this bottom face, select this top face, hit okay. Select this top face, or this back face, hit okay. This face, okay. Instead of inserting another component, we're just gonna mirror it. So mirror component, and our mirror plane is going to be, hit this drop-down menu, it's gonna be the right, and the component is gonna be the cab, hit over, and hit okay. And let's finish that off by adding the top part of the cab frame. Insert component, set insert component and grabbing a new part. Let's just hover over on the tree and hit cap train and hit control C and then select somewhere on the window, hit control V. We'll just copy and paste another part. So we're gonna constrain that. So mates, select that face, this face, this face, and you can see it's going into the surface, and I'm like trying to select this face and then the top face. Pull it back, hit the mate, select that face, and there it is. Now let's insert the smoke box. Insert component, browse, smoke box. Just drop it somewhere there. Let's do the mate. that face, this face, this face, this face, and back to this face. Cool. And we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna copy that component. Hit Control C, Control V, copies it for us. And we can just define that piece as well. Hit Mate, select this face, move forward, select this face, select that face. And we need to constrain it to the top body. And hit that face. So there you go, it's starting to look like a train. Now let's add our dome and our chimney. So insert component, browse, chimney, just grab it somewhere. And so hit mate, grab this inner circle, and grab this, and that grabs, that makes it concentric. Now we gotta define the Y, hit that face, hit that, okay. So we're gonna do the same thing with the dome. So select it somewhere, hit mate, select that inner circle, that circle, this face, and this face. So what's left now is to insert our wheels. So do that, insert, browse, wheels, like that. Mate, grab that, grab that. Let's grab this face and then this face. Hit okay, hit F to zoom back into our workspace. Okay, now we wanna rinse and repeat. We can do it this way, we can just keep adding each component, or we can just be a little bit more clever and we can go insert to the drop-down menu, copy with mates, select the component you wanna copy, hit okay. And then now we can just select the first concentric mate, and then we can select the coincident, and boom, it pops it in for us. Hit okay, and then now we can do the same thing. Hit that guy, hit this face, okay. We're good, now we can exit out, and now all we have to do now is just mirror the components. So we hit mirror, mid plane is gonna be the right again. All right, now we can just select the three bodies, or the three wheels, hit okay. And there you guys have it. The assembly is all done. Now let's make an exploded view. So let's hover over to the Configure Manager, select the right click default, hit new exploded. And we're gonna just grab the three wheels, and you can grab these arrows and pull it out this direction. Okay, and we're gonna grab the other three wheels, pull it out the other direction. And then we're gonna grab the chimney and the frame and the dome, and we'll just pull it up. Same thing with the, and then we're gonna do the same thing with the cab. We can just grab the cab, pull it up, and then we can just grab it, these, and then just pull it back. And then just grab this frame, pull it up. Oop. Hit Control Z, I didn't want that, just want it. Clear the thresh, just wanted to grab the bottom frame here and the smoke boxes and go up. And now we're done, we're okay. We can see that this is our exploded view, and we want to add some trail lines to kind of connect the dots if somebody wanted to like put this back together. Pretty simple, just right click the exploded view, add smart exploded lines, and it automatically propagates that for you. And there it is. So one cool thing about this exploded view is you can, if you want to go back and collapse it, just go over to the explode, hit collapse and do that. Or if you want to explode it, hit explode. Or if you want to do an animation and send it off to somebody to see how everything goes in, you can do that and save it out. And you can animate the collapse. So either one. And there you guys have it. This is the assembly of the Lego train. Give it a try. I hope you learned something new. To watch the next part of the beginner series, I'll leave a link somewhere up here. Anyways, I hope this video was helpful. If it was, do me a favor and give it a like and subscribe because it really helps me out. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.